Good afternoon. We'll start with pictures just coming into our newsroom right now of severe storm cells lashing parts of the state's north and inland to the central west. These pictures taken in Tamworth, where residents say the hailstones are the biggest they have ever seen. Let's go to our weather expert, Gary Youngbury. Gary, of course, it's springtime. It's not unusual for New South Wales. You're in Brisbane at the moment and you've been lashed by a new round of thunderstorms just now. What a scary night and a scary day. What's going on?
Well, as you mentioned, Davina, we are being lashed here at the moment. You can probably hear the thunder and lightning in the background here in southeast Queensland. But for northern New South Wales, this line of storms extends all the way just about across eastern Australia. But places like Tamworth in the northwest, slopes and plains, to see hail that large this early in thunderstorm season certainly is a little rare. And it's not just in the northwest. I know the central west, the town of Dubbo, the suburbs there, looking with a tinge of white at the moment as hailstones cover their lawns. So it's occurring right down through the central parts of New South Wales. But we are being smashed here in southeast Queensland as we speak. We've just had some very heavy, possibly flooding rain move through. We can hear sirens in the background. I'm in the suburb of Caboolture at the moment, where most of the rain has been falling over the last 30 minutes or so. But there's been a big line of storms crossing from near the border of New South Wales, Queensland, right through to the central coast. And in the next half an hour, it'll be the Sunshine Coast, likely to see very heavy rainfall, destructive winds, and also possible hailstones. So, Davina, as I mentioned, a large line of severe thunderstorms crossing southeast Queensland, northern New South Wales. It is round two for us here in Queensland.
And the severe storm threat across New South Wales covers mostly about a third of the state right now at the moment. So we're in for a bumpy afternoon. Gary, thank you so much. Well, an alleged drunk driver has ploughed into a garage in Western Sydney, narrowly missing a woman who was fast asleep in the front bedroom of the Ruby Hill home. Police say the 21-year-old man returned a breath test almost three times the legal limit. He'll appear in Mount Druitt local court in early December. The Qatari government says it regrets any distress caused to the women invasively searched at Doha Airport, as it's revealed more people were involved in the incident than first reported. Let's bring in our political reporter Jonathan Kersley in Canberra. Jono, good afternoon to you. Prime Minister Scott Morrison has now spoken.
He has, Davina, and he says what happened was appalling and a warning viewers may find some of this following detail distressing. 13 Australian women were taken off a Qatar Airways flight and subjected to examinations without consent after a baby was found inside Doha Airport. A Senate hearing today here in Canberra was told 18 women in all were taken off that flight earlier this month. And Australian authorities now believe passengers on 10 flights were affected. Qatar's government says the baby was found in a bin and is now safe. In a statement, the Qatari government said, "This egregious and life-threatening violation of the law triggered an immediate search for the parents, including on flights in the vicinity of where the newborn was found. The state of Qatar regrets any distress or infringement on the personal freedoms of any traveller caused by this action." Now, Foreign Minister Maurice Payne has spoken to the Qatari ambassador, but not to her counterpart in Qatar. The Australian government is now waiting for the Qatar government's report into the matter before deciding what further action, if any, it will take. He's the Prime Minister.
We are appalled by what occurred, as anyone would, not just as an Australian, but any traveller would. They should not be subject to these invasive procedures.
Davina, Qatar is Australia's second largest trading partner in the Middle East. It is also supposed to be the host nation of the 2022 Soccer World Cup, which Australia bid for. Former Socceroo Craig Foster says football's governing body, FIFA, should now be looking into what he says are clear human rights violations.
The point is that any nation that wants to host an international major sporting event has to abide by certain basic human rights.
The 13 Australian women were taken off a Qatar Airways flight. Well, that was the airline involved in this incident. That airline is also responsible for returning about 15% of Australians at the moment, and there are no plans to stop those flights from arriving, Davina.
Jonathan Kersley, live in Canberra, thank you. Well, it's perhaps fitting that on our National Memorial Day for Fire and Emergency Services, the Royal Commission report into the Black Summer bushfires has been handed to the Governor-General. The government is expected to release the findings on Friday, and earlier today the Prime Minister paid tribute to those killed fighting the fires.
Some of them came from across the seas to be here at our moment of greatest need, and we remember them and we think of their families who deal with their loss every single day.
Several of those who lost homes and livelihoods protested outside Parliament, demanding action on climate change. Well, videos are circulating on social media this afternoon showing students evacuating Bomaderry High School on the south coast due to a potential bomb threat.
Working at a school and we're all getting evacuated. Going to be stuck here for 3 hours.
It's just hours after a police strike force was created to investigate threatening emails sent to 30 schools across the state in the last 2 days, disrupting and even cancelling some HSC exams. Mark Burrows will join us in the next half an hour to go into more detail with what the strike force has now had to say.